Hi guys, wish you a happy Father's Day, and I am going to be right now in conversation with the lovely Tamanna and her father Santosh. So please do join us in. I'm just waiting for Tamanna to log on. I'm good. Thank you guys. Your messages are coming very fast. I'm waiting for Tamanna to send me a request and join us live. Hey Shadab, hey Bobby. Hey Tammy. I've sent you a request.
Now the most challenging part, putting the camera in place. Okay then. Yeah.
Happy Father's Day.
Happy Father's Day to you. That's my dad.
Hello.
Happy Father's Day to you too.
How are you, sir?
So what did you, how did you celebrate today?
We've just been sleeping and eating and chilling and doing nothing.
Yeah. Eating what?
Eating ghar ka khana and samosa have been made and all yummy food.
My most basic question, what is the kind of relationship you share with your dad? Is it like very formal beta daughter, beta father kind of stuff? Or is it more casual? What is the kind of relationship
you share? Do you want to know from me or you want him to answer this question?
I want you to answer this question.
Okay. So for me, see, unlike a lot of kids of my age, I did not actually go to, college, like a major educational institution after school. I spent a lot of my growing up years with my parents, primarily dad, because he's been taking care of my work, as you know, since I was very, very young. And so a lot of my guidance of what I am today comes from his understanding of life. So most of my early life has been, you know, primarily whatever, whoever I was a lot of influence of my father. And I think personality wise also I'm a lot like him. I'm actually a female version of him, which I don't know if many people know.
Give me an example.
Like small thing, our habits are the same. Like if I can tell you like a weird detail, our toes look the same. Our temperaments are very similar. My mom always cribs because she's like the victim of the fact that we are so like each other, and that really pisses her off. And she's not in the room right now, so I can say this, but I'm like a lot like my dad and lesser like my mom, and she hates it when I say that. So our rapport today, of course, as a kid it was different, but today it's a lot like friends and dad. We still work together, so we spend a lot of time, and our interests are very similar in the sense of most of our conversations end up for us, neither for him nor for me, work has ever been like work. It's been something we actually enjoy. So that's what we kind of mostly bond on. We end up chatting about this and that, and that's how the rapport is.
What about you, Uncle? Are there any major disagreements you have? What are the places that you disagree with Tamanna on?
Broadly speaking, there are no major disagreements. There can be a difference of perception, difference of view on certain things. And then we
like what? Give me an example.
Huh?
Give me an instance that both of you were completely
different.
Nothing really. Actually, I'm not even exaggerating this, but really nothing.
I have to really think hard.
No. So you don't have a difference of opinion.
No, it's more like me and mom tend we tend to have a difference of opinion a lot more than me and my dad. And it's inevitably like my dad and me on one team and my mom on the other side. And she really she's like, you know, I have two people like the same, just like a male version and a female version living with them. It's like I think next time you should interview her. So you'll have
then you'll know what the difference is.
Tell me, do you confide in your dad? Do you tell him about your heartbreaks, boyfriends, or you're very careful? Dad, I have a crush on this guy. Do you tell him stuff like that?
He knows.
Almost everything, whatever.
Whatever in my entire personal life, I think has been extremely transparent to my parents, particularly because I feel like this is one aspect of my life. Because my life is anyway out there so much in public. I feel like the most things that are the most closest to me, I want to be the most transparent to my parents because that's my comfort. That's my comfort zone. That's where I can be me without having to put any filter, without having to pretend to be anyone. I'm lucky I have it at home. I know a lot of people who do not have that rapport with their parents. And also, I think as Indian kids, we always get looked upon as we live with our parents and... you know, how do we manage living with our parents even when we grow older, much older? Of course, a lot of people in my generation also who live on their own, which is great. But I just feel so comfortable, you know, living with my parents and, you know, the kind of freedom they've given me to become the best version of myself. I don't think I could have lived this kind of a life living alone. And I don't even think I'm that kind of a person who can live alone because I love that chahal pahal and I love that whole drama at home and I love like 10 things happening at the same time. So yeah.
Uncle, how have you seen her grow, evolve, mature over the years? Give me an instance where you've seen her really, you know, mature and take decisions and, you know. Because, see, this is a very vulnerable profession. Everybody's so vulnerable. Right. You know, you need to be... you need family support, protection.
Right.
What are the changes that you've seen in her?
Yeah, to start with, since she started very young. Even when she was less than 15. And so, I and my wife, we both were all the time with her for the initial 2 or 3 years. We should travel with her all the time. And then as slowly I started withdrawing. My wife used to relieve my wife to be with her. So, but one thing I can tell you, professionally, she has been on her own from the day one. We have never, tried to advise her or how she has to do her work professionally. So that is one area which we already stepped off. So we believed in her, and she knows her job. And over the period of time, she evolved, with her work. And the confidence and the delivery, whatever she had to, as far as her work is concerned, has been growing from point to point, is going higher only and getting better. So we were basically a support system for her. And as she grew bigger, older, we in her personal space, we started backing off. So to give her own freedom of choice or whatever she would want to do. And even in the choice of whatever the purchase she would want to have for herself. Or so those were also slowly, she would take a call and we started taking...
Because I had this habit, whenever I would go shopping, I'm not someone who can shop alone. So if I were in a position that I have to shop alone, I have to make a call and check ki main kharidu ki nahi kharidu. So a call will go to my dad and a call will go to my mother. And especially when I'm making these like slightly expensive buy, I'll have like this entire discussion on, okay, whether is this worth it, or should I like invest in this, or should I not invest in this? And they're like, listen, you know, you work so hard, just do whatever you want, it's your money.
And you know, I in fact, most of the time, even if I thought it was something which was somewhat more expensive, I would feel that it is better to go with her choice, because she has to experience that, okay, this is what I bought, it was too expensive, next time, so that's how she will learn. So we always kept giving her the choice of making the decision. Even though she would refer back to us, we will still, you know, go with her decision. So that is how, you know, it went on. And then...
What about her movie choices? Have you disagreed with her on any of her choices?
Choices in movies? No, not really. As I said,
no.
Her professional choices, we never, you know, even after the film is released, it is done good or bad, we never talk about it.
So how it works is that at my place, it's like I am the, if I were to define how we work as a team, is I am the creative aspect of it, and Dad is the commercial aspect of it. Like he handles all my work in terms of
commercial
and the operational aspect of it. And so I don't interfere on that side of his, like his part, because that's another, just like our, like this kind of a, this is like how a business or how you would run a company, you know, you need two sides to it, right? So I feel like somewhere I have the beautiful balance of, you know, being, letting myself creatively go, you know, to my, you know, to whatever my imagination, to where it goes and to what I can explore. And then I have that backing where, you know, Dad takes care of the commercial aspect and, you know, makes it a good,
combination.
Yeah.
Is there any film of hers that you've really liked over the years, and you know, it's a particular favorite with you?
Okay, the film that
it could be Tamil, it could be Telugu.
Yes. The film I particularly liked was Happy Days. That was the early part of her career, and in the middle part of her career, there was the remake of Jab We Met. And of course, the later part of career, it is Bahubali. So, it is, these are the three major films of hers which we love.
He's told you a like a pan India film. Very smart. Like,
smart. Is there an event in your life which, you know, got you all really closer, and you know, you understood him better, he understood you better? Is there any kind of event that, you know, was like a life-changing moment in your relationship?
I feel like I don't think it was Filmfare that this happened on, like a performance of Filmfare. It was some other award show I was performing for, but I actually had cold feet just before a performance on stage.
I think it was Vijay TV Awards.
It was some TV Awards. Yeah, now on your account, people will know what award function that was. But I actually had a very bad cold feet. Very, very bad. Like, to a point where I called up my dad backstage and I was like, can we run? Like, can we give the money back and just run? Or something. I had some bizarre, like, I was very bizarre that I was freaking out, and I was like, how can I do this? I don't know my steps. I can't remember anything. So I was totally tripping on that zone. So Dad was like, listen, you have rehearsed so much, you know your thing. What will happen? You forget your steps. No, that's okay.
And you've done so many shows and
no,
so well.
That one particular show, I had some major cold feet happening. And I think he really, really calmed me down. And that was one of the times where I understood that, yes, we are creative people. Yes, we are very passionate about our job. Yes, we want to do our best. But we're also human, you know. And somewhere your family comes into play when they make you realize that it's okay to make a mistake. It's okay to be wrong. It's okay to not be able to give your best every single time. It's okay to not feel your best every single time. You know? So I feel like And this is one instance I'm telling you. There were times I had some serious box office failures. Some of my Hindi films that did very badly. I got a lot of flack for it. I got a lot of negativity for it. But I think my parents really cushioned me at that point of time. And they were like, "Are you know what? It's a part of my job. It's okay to have failures in your work. It's like a bad day at work. It's not like you haven't failed. Your film has failed. So just putting that sense into a person when you are vulnerable, when you are not feeling your best, I think that has been that those instances have been times where I got closer to my dad and I understood that his presence is what keeps me grounded and makes me realize a more larger picture of life. You know, not just one spectrum ki film mein hai, because I'm also I'm a little obsessive about work. So, you know, film mein matlab it's not life. There's also life around it. So just kind of that balance came through my father.
And let me end with a cliche question. Does he at all ask you about marriage or, you know, suno abhi time hai, settle karo? Do you ever tell her that?
You ask him this question. You don't Santu. Ask
him. Yeah, yeah.
Again, this is one area we confer and we discuss openly. And there is hardly a disagreement in this. We are actually on the same page. And I and my wife, we are fine with her making a choice. And if we have critical points to, make it known to her, then we make it known to her. These are our observations. And then we leave it to her. This is how, you know, but we discuss at every point in time, every stage of.
Yes, Jitesh, to answer your question, like every other girl on the planet, my parents ask me, do you want to get married? When do you want to get married? When do you want to have kids? This question is asked to me also. I am just like everyone else.
Tell me, if you are in a bad relationship or you had a boyfriend which they didn't approve of, does your dad say, "Maine bola tha wo theek nahi hai. Maine bola to tumko wo theek nahi hai." Has that a situation ever arisen?
So, whenever I've had... actually, my parents have been very like silent observers. Like they never actually, they let me realize on my own what is happening. Of course, they always give the, like he said, they always give their opinion. But they never enforce anything. Like, say, you cannot. Like, bahar nahi ja sakte. Mil nahi sakte. That nothing like, no filmy drastic thing would happen. But they always give their opinion, which, and they let me brood over it. And and then if I realize, then, chalo, matlab naseeb acha hai. If I didn't realize, then...
Okay, I'll leave you two to grappling with one another professionally, personally. It's been wonderful chatting with you. I hope you have a great Father's Day. And I think you should now prepare something interesting for him today as a token of appreciation.
I have something actually. Iske baad.
Yeah?
Iske baad kuch plan hai. अभी सरप्राइज है मैं सरप्राइज बोल दूंगी तो कैसे मालूम होएगा
अच्छा ओके 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 थैंक यू फॉर बीइंग हियर थैंक यू सो मच फॉर बीइंग विद इन स्पेशल
थैंक यू
सो मच बाय बाय